We will use these two pieces of foam to simulate some of the interactions along a plate boundary where most earthquakes tend to originate. There is variation in the shape along the edges of the foam where they will be in contact. We will try to move plate A very slowly to the north and plate B very slowly to the west. Each person is pushing on their plate to get it to start moving. The person pushing on plate B will increase the magnitude of the external force they are applying to it to move it to the west. Watch what happens as the magnitude of the force continues to increase. Both people will continue applying external forces to the plate. Imagine you can observe a zoomed-in location along the plate boundary as they do this again, and the magnitude of the external force on plate B slowly increases. What would you see happening to the matter at these locations? Scientists believe the hypocenter of many earthquakes occurs as a result of one of two things. Either the frictional forces between the tectonic plates change in magnitude enough to cause slip at a specific location where they are in contact, similar to trying to slide your shoe along the floor, something that will happen only once you push on it hard enough. In this case, the solid rock only elastically deforms where this happens. In other cases, the slip occurs when only a certain amount of permanent deformation or breaking also occurs at a particular point in the matter. Consider why these particular pieces of foam would have cracked and broken off apart from the larger piece of material they were attached to. What, if anything, was different about the matter at the locations where the matter broke off versus where it did not? What, if anything, was different about the forces acting on the matter at those locations?